In a medical malpractice case, if I ask a doctor during his pretrial questioning, his deposition, whether or not he screwed up and caused my client harm and injury, what do you think he's going to say? He's going to say, no, of course not. But if instead I ask it a different way, I can guarantee that I will always get an answer that either tells me he did violate the basic standard of medical care, or he's fighting with me and says, no, I did not violate the basic standard of medical care. You want to know what this is all about? Come join me for a moment as I show you some great information. Hi, I'm Jerry Ojinski. I'm a New York medical malpractice and personal injury attorney. And during a medical malpractice case, I will have an opportunity to question the doctor whom you have sued. And one of the things that I will ask the doctor is, doctor, did you cause my client harm? He's going to say, of course not. I did nothing wrong. Nothing I did caused or contributed to your client's injuries. Her injuries are because of something else. Or it's a known risk of the procedure. Or it's nothing I did. She caused or contributed to her own injuries. If I turn the questions around, instead of confronting the doctor directly, what if instead I were to ask the doctor, excuse me, doctor, what is the standard of care when a patient comes in with these complaints? What does a good doctor do? Oh, he does A, B, and C. Okay, and would you agree it's appropriate for a doctor to do A, B, and C? You take vital signs, you draw bloods, you take a detailed, thorough history. Yes, yes, yes. Now, doctor, would you agree that a physician who fails to do one or all three of those things, that would be a violation from the basic standard of medical care? And now he has no choice but to admit that. Yes, why? Because he's just told me what the standard of care required. I'm just turning the question around, saying, listen, if a doctor did not do any one of those things, would you agree it would be a departure from good medical practice? And he has to say yes. He has to admit that. So now I'll take it further. Doctor, I don't want you to assume that this patient came in with the following complaints. Would you agree that in that instance it's appropriate to do A, B, and C? Yes, it would. Doctor, would you agree that if a physician who sees a patient with the following complaints did not do A or B or C, that would be a departure from good care? Yes, it would. And now later on, I will ask him to go through his notes, his medical record of this patient, and I'll ask him whether he did A, B, and C. And if he didn't, I'm going to ask him why not. And then I'll ultimately ask him, doctor, would you agree that failing to do A, B, or C would be a violation from the basic standard of medical care? And you know what? He has to agree. Why? Because he told me what the standard of care was. He told me what happens if a physician does not do any one of those things. And now we're using this patient's actual medical records to now contrast what was actually good practice compared to what he actually did. So why do I share this quick information with you? I share it with you just to give you an insight and an understanding into what goes on in these medical malpractice cases here in New York. You know, I understand you're watching this video because you likely have questions or concerns about your own matter. Well, if your matter did happen here in New York and you still have not yet brought a lawsuit because you have questions that need answers, what I invite you to do is pick up the phone and call me. I can answer your legal questions. You know, this is something I do every single day and I'd love to talk to you. You can reach me at 516-487-8207 or by email at Jerry, G-E-R-R-Y, at Ojinski-Law.com. That's it for today's video. I'm Jerry Ojinski. Have a wonderful day.